Hey there, I want to keep that rant going that I started last week. You know, I was talking about this epidemic where I see startup coaches and entrepreneurs deciding that their prospects can't afford their services, even before they talk to them. Before they have a sample session or that discovery consultation, they make up their mind that those people can't afford my services. They already have the no in place. We talked about how it might be a fear of success, a fear of failure, a fear of disappointing them. And so we kind of sabotage ourselves and we make it a no to protect ourselves as self-defense so that it's easier to handle. But you're pushing away possibilities and you have to stop doing that. If you are going to be your own boss, if you're going to have your own business and you're going to find clients and do the work you love to do, you have to be able to show up to these conversations in healthy ways. And there's three things I want to remind you of to do instead, rather than assume the no, so that you can actually position yourself for the yeses. And the first thing is to mind your own business. You're making up the mind for your clients or your potential clients and your prospects before you ever talk to them. That's none of your business. Your business is to present the case. Your business is to present the journey of transformation. Your business is to convey the benefits when somebody does experience coaching. What is the transformation? How will that impact their life? That's your business. That's what you focus on, doing that the best way you can. Let them tend to their business of figuring out, is this a journey they want to take? What will that mean to them? Are they ready and committed? And are they willing to do this? When they make those decisions for themselves, then they will figure out how to hire you. They may not know how, they may not know where the money is coming from, but when they know the impact and the value that coaching has on their lives, and they make a decision from a place of commitment, they'll figure out how to find the investment. I've seen it many times. People can't afford it, but then they find a way to do it, to invest and say yes, and experience a transformation. But you're not even giving them the opportunity, and that is not fair. You are cutting that opportunity out from under them. You're not even giving them the chance to say yes to themselves when that's what they really want to do. That is not coaching at all. That's dictating, and that's not the work that you do. So mind your own business. If you're not sure about that, one of the things that you can do is really get clear on how to structure an enrollment conversation so that you can convey the value, the journey, the benefit, the impact, so that they can make a clear and conscious decision. That's your business. That's what you can handle. The second thing that you can do is you can, let me just check my notes here, you can stay open to possibilities. Now, a lot of times we don't stay open to possibilities because we have our own limiting beliefs and gremlins and what we call villains creeping up and showing up. One of the best ways to combat that when it comes to money and I can't afford things is from my good friend Barbara Stanney. And she has written this book, Overcoming Under-Earning. If you have not read that and you're an entrepreneur, I believe it's the Bible that should sit on your desk, along with a few other books as well. But that's one of the books that you should dive into to make sure you've worked through your money stuff. Because if you're showing up to this conversation and you have money issues, you're gonna project that crap onto whoever's sitting in front of you. And you'll probably decide that they can't afford it because it's probably the story going on in your brain. So make sure that you stay open to possibilities and you sort out your issues. And this is a great way to do this. You can see mine is dog-eared and I've got post-it notes and I write in it and mark it up. And you're gonna love it if you have not read it. Overcoming Under-Earning, one of my favorite all-times books. And then the third thing to do is to make sure you have a system in place. So often I see with entrepreneurs is they try to find clients, they find one option, they try to have a conversation, it doesn't work. Now they're back to square one. It's a lot of heavy lifting when you're trying to find them one at a time. But instead, have a system in place, a system to allow you to find leads and new clients and new contacts, a system to automate the follow-up to those leads so that they can be invited to have a conversation with you and take action on hiring you, and have a system to follow up on the people that are a yes, and have a system to follow up on people that are a no, not yet. When you have systems into place and you can work the system, hearing a no is no big deal because you have a system in place on how to be of service and handle the no, not yets. So your system handles them while you then focus on the next yes coming in the door. But if you don't have these systems, every no is detrimental. Every no is crushing. It's hard on the ego. It's hard on your heart. It's hard on the passion. Having a system allows you to keep working the system because you're going to have so many conversations. Numbers say you have to have so many conversations to get a certain number of yeses. So you are going to hear no's and prepare yourself for that, but don't assume the no. So mind your own business, stay open to possibility, and have systems into place to handle the no's and the yeses so that you can keep moving no matter how somebody makes a decision. Got it? All right, I've got some more things that I want to share with you because I do want to give you some insight in how to structure the conversation so that you can mind your own business and actually bring to the conversation what you need to bring to give them the opportunity to say yes to themselves. That's what's really going on here. They're not saying yes to hiring you. That's how they're going to get the benefit and the results that they want. But what they're really doing is saying yes to themselves, and you better give them the opportunity to do that. I'll keep my rant going in the next one. Stay tuned for more.